Before COVID-19, most physicians, including me, thought that a face-to-face consultation is the only effective means of a doctor-patient relation and rapport. But during this lockdown, one of my patients, he was recovering after a cancer treatment. He called me and told about difficulty in swallowing. He was at a distance without any good local medical facility around. This forced me into an overnight arranged marriage with the telemedicine. I asked him to give me a video call and demonstrate his difficulty. In turn, I demonstrated him some swallowing exercises, and to my surprise, after a few days I got a call from him with dramatic improvement in his problem, and he was asking for further course of action. That day, I fell in love with telemedicine. This changed my perspective about telemedicine, and I started working on it. And now I can confidently say that I can reduce my OPD attendance effectively as much as 30-40% without compromising on the patient care. And I am here in front of you to advocate the benefits of telemedicine. So friends, what is telemedicine? Telemedicine is nothing but a doctor's consultation on your phone, WhatsApp, Facebook, internet, etc. It not only prevents the spread of infection like corona, but also it allows you for a timely, faster and easy access of healthcare facilities which are not around, and it cuts down on your travel time. It also saves your medical records electronically so that in future you don't have to carry the big x-rays and reports which generally all of us forget. Now let's see who all will benefit with telemedicine. Working professionals don't have to take a half day or full day leave just to see a doctor. Rather, they can utilize it to watch a movie or a match. Homemakers don't have to reschedule their task or miss their daily soap opera. Old and infirm, for whom travel and waiting is a tedious task and are also at high risk of catching an infection. People in remote areas where health facilities are not available easily. So friends, telemedicine is practically beneficial to everyone.
अरे भाई, इतने फायदे की चीज है तो फिर अब तक थी कहाँ? Because there were no guidelines in the National Medical Council and therefore it was not legal in India before Corona. But the good news is the National Medical Council has come out with guidelines in consultation with Niti Aayog, and they have notified it also in the gazette that the telemedicine can be utilized in India as recent as few weeks ago. Now the next question is how to consult on telemedicine platform. Although it can be consulted by any means of communication, but the best way is by using some mobile app, as these are a one-stop solution for all your healthcare needs, like not only consultation but the home blood tests, medicines, allied services like physiotherapy, dietitian, etc. And these apps also address certain inherent problems of telemedicine like medical records and confidentiality of the records. Now, the preferred type of consultation on telemedicine are the first consultation, where preferably a video call is to be done to establish the identity of both patient as well as the doctor with exchange of some information. If the doctor is able to establish a diagnosis, then he will be able to prescribe some treatment, counseling, education, or he may advise some test or an appropriate referral if he is not able to advise medicine on teleconsultation. The second type of consultation is a follow-up consultation, which is the preferred consultation for telemedicine, because your doctor has already established your identity and he knows you physically, so the follow-up consultations are best suited by teleconsultation. The follow-up consultation can also be used to show reports or to check progress on your disease. This is the sample of the prescription which the National Medical Council has issued for the teleconsultation. Your doctor must identify his name, his registration with the medical council, and he should always put his signatures and stamp below the prescription. The registration number is very important in order to authenticate your doctor, because by this registration number you can identify the doctor's registration in the medical council register. And if this prescription is issued, then the legal standing of this prescription is as good as a consultation in person. Now you will ask whether the telemedicine is covered under insurance.
So yes, of course, it is covered. If your insurance company gives you cover for OPD consultation, then teleconsultation is as good as that.
So friends, what are the diseases which are best suited for teleconsultation? The most important is the skin ailments, because you can show your doctor the lesion on the skin, any problem of the tongue or oral cavity,
eye ailments for the trauma and emergency, and also we can send our images and pathology slides to another person for opinion. Secondly, this telemedicine is very good for second opinions, because you have already consulted a doctor and you have all the reports with you. You can consult any expert of that particular field anywhere in the world by just sharing your data, and he will give an opinion. Now, there are certain limitations also. Teleconsultation lacks the comfort and confidence of a doctor-patient personal interaction, which is an age-old phenomenon. We cannot do any surgical or any other intervention on telemedicine, and of course, there are issues of confidentiality of the data. Another important limitation of teleconsultation is certain medicines which are scheduled in the National Medical Council's index, which cannot be prescribed by a teleconsultation.
To conclude, telemedicine is an effective, efficient, and safe tool if used judiciously, and it has been underutilized. However, during and after this pandemic, we have and we will emerge confident to use telemedicine as an effective tool as utilized by any other profession. So, hey friends, if you liked the video and the information and found it useful, please share it with others, and for regular updates, follow me at my YouTube channel Dr. DK, a doctor one click away, and my Facebook page Head and Neck Onco Surgeon. Thanks for watching.